joined today with the noted cartoonist, and he is none other than, yes, I'll show the man over there. Yes, he is none other than Champak Borbora. Yes, Champak sir, welcome to our show.
Thank you, Andrew.
So viewers, I'm sure you must be glued to your television because Champak Borbora is here, the noted cartoonist of the Assam Tribune. He is with the Assam Tribune, and the section Joko Serious, which comes up with the Assam Tribune, is done with this man who is with me right now. So I'll straight away go to him and talk a lot about whatever things he do and how the Joko Serious comes up in the Assam Tribune. So sir, all about cartoon and your take on this, and how did you start the journey?
Actually, my cartoon journey started late 70s, okay. during the Assam movement. Hmm. Then I was in Jorhat.
Okay.
And actually, I'm basically a painter. I like to paint.
Okay.
But at the time, I find that something happens in our society or politically, which can express in painting. So I took the support of cartoon. Mm-hmm. Then the Haptahik Janamhumi, that was published from, at the time, that was published from Jorhat.
Okay.
And I continued to draw some cartoons there every week. And then I shifted from Jorhat to Guwahati. Mm-hmm. And then joined the Sentinel. Hmm. Then my job was not the cartoonist. Hmm. I frequently, time to time, when I feel some topics to do cartoons, I did there. Then I joined the Sentinel, like my journey continued.
Then like you pen down every of your like whatever thoughts, whatever ideas it came to your mind, and you pen down everything in that Joko Serious section of Assam Tribune. We have been following that from quite a long time. So what do you have to say on that?
I've joined the Assam Tribune in 1995. Hmm. But then I appointed a cartoonist. Then I commit to do cartoon. I compelled to do cartoons. But I know the language. First thing, the cartoon language is different from paintings. Okay. So you have to, some humor should be there, and you have some you have to convey some thoughts to the readers. So like that, it is difficult to say how I do cartoons. Thing is there, but. The readers know what cartoon is, I think.
Mm-hmm. And it's very difficult for our viewer to make them laugh or make them smile. So a very important work which you have taken up, and you make all of us smile by all the cartoons which you put up in the Joko Serious section. And whatever the imagination, how do you get those imagination and you pen down everything in that?
Actually, our society is the happening. All the happenings in the
society. We have taken the topics which you take up.
And the political scene. Many funny things are going on there. I have to pick up this idea grows with the happenings always. Mm-hmm. And it is the I stylize it to cartoons.
Like you never think before like what I have to do now or what I'll publish tomorrow, but the things which are happening, as you say, that suppose today some incident happened or some political development came up or some kind of like entertainment development came up, so you just imagine those things and then you
When some topics are coming, how I'm react to the thing, that is the main thing, and how I convey to my readers. And I always stand for the common people.
Okay.
Common people. So I always make myself to the part of the common people's sentiments.
Then only you can connect to them.
Yeah. That's my idea.
That's your idea. A very good thought, sir. And like you connect with the viewers and you connect with their thoughts, and then things come out so well that our viewers also like it so much. So Champak sir, again I'm coming back to you. So as you said it, apart from cartoonist, but you are actually a painter. You have fond of like you passion.
Yes, sir.
Painting is your passion. So, how much time do you spend a lot of time for your painting, and how do you manage time with the cartoon section? Okay, please tell us.
Things like that, all the working hours, like all the daytime, I have to give for the cartoons. I'm for the office hours, no? I have to work there. And I do illustrations also for Assam Tribune.
Okay.
And the thing is that the other time, the rest of the time, I devote myself to the painting. And the painting is not like that thing that, it's just something emotional. Right? You have some mood to do painting. So, not that I do painting every day. But I try to devote myself to painting.
Which is your passion. And we have also seen some of your pictures, like you have been going to some of the exhibitions of some schools and inaugurating their exhibitions. Saw a picture of South Point School and some of other schools also. So what kind of like feeling you get when you see some young talents coming up with a beautiful painting, and what advice do you want to give to them?
Actually, there are a lot of youngsters coming up, those are doing very good paintings and drawings. That is an inspiration for us, like me, because they are our future.
Absolutely.
And what we carry, that will carry by
will be carried forward by
them. And that is the happiness. That is the happiness. And the thing is that the time, our time and their time is changing, no? There is now the digital age is coming, all these things are going to be digitalized. But the thing is that when I was talked to children of the Southeast, South Point School, that the analog system, and the thing is that our hand is the got created digitals. We have to depend on other details. Our hand is connected to straight to our brain, no?
Okay.
Brain
so
and emotion. So when you go to the digital one should first practice analog analog system. Then one should go to the digital.
We must say it's a God gift for all of you and all for you. Could you please tell us that from where did you like started doing art, and where did you learn?
Actually, basically, I don't have any academic or formal training on art.
Okay.
I've learned by myself.
Okay. So you must be having some ideals.
I have some, but in Assam,
whom you are following from very tender age.
I inherit the trend. There are a lot of renowned painters in Assam, like Nilpavan Bora, Benu Misra, Subha Brahmo. Earlier than but our tradition is not too much old. It started, the modern period started from 1930s only, where in other part of the India started much before that. Some others renowned painter of the world like Van Gogh, like M.F. Hussein, many other artists inspired me.
And we would also like to know your favorite cartoonist.
R.K. Laxman is my favorite.
Okay.
And another is David Lowe, is the British cartoonist. Yeah, they are both are my favorite. There are other cartoonists also like Abu Abraham from India, and Mario Beranda, and Kuti. And they are very sensible cartoonists.
Right. and following them and penning down there and imagining they're like them would be a great thing to do in your work. So sir, we were talking about many things like how you came to cartoon, and like you said that you are fond of painting and that is your passion, and how much time you take out to do these kind of things, and you have inspired a lot of viewers over there. So we would also want to know what kind of themes you pick up when you think about any of the cartoon you would pen down.
I told earlier that how I react to some happenings.
Mm-hmm.
First
the things
thing,
which happen.
The topic, how I select.
Mm-hmm.
Then the process of creating a cartoon is something different.
Mm.
Sometimes it comes like a spark.
Mm.
You shouldn't have any time to create a cartoon.
Mm-hmm.
But, to bring the idea, then I have to mold and the whole thing, you know, the construct the I construct the cartoons.
Mm.
But sometimes it took lots of times, hours after hours, mm-hmm. to find out. The thing is that the happenings in our society always almost the same, like the collapse.
The things happening inspires you a lot.
We are doing actually ki we are some anti-establishment. We are always anti-establishment.
Mm-hmm.
So things happenings in the society or the political is always like the corruption, the rape, or these things are happening.
Mm-hmm.
But I have to always to create or say things in a new way.
New way.
Yeah.
And quite a lot of time takes up for doing this. So how much editing you do to your work? Like if suppose you have done a cartoon, you have drawn a cartoon or you have done a painting. So how much editing do you do to your work?
No,
or is it fine by one or two?
Always I concentrate in one topic.
Hmm.
I don't want to diffuse from it, no, but divert it. But the thing is, I have to justify it logically.
Hmm.
How much it is rational before leaving it to viewers or the readers.
Mm-hmm.
I have to justify it first. It should not be maligned first.
Yeah.
It should not. It should be always impersonal.
Mm.
Though it is a rational thing, it is it should not malign anybody. That is the important
to work with. Okay. And if you would like to ask you that, what is the incident or which has inspired you, or some incident which has, like suppose you said that you imagine a lot and things which are happening, day-to-day happenings, you pen down in your cartoon. So what are the incidents like you have penned down in your cartoon, and some interesting facts we would also want to know?
First thing, that the thing is that I always convey some possibilities.
Mm.
That should not be. That is the something you can say, warning to the doers who do this thing. No? The last, I have not released this cartoons like that.
Mm.
Something happens. Like our dresses are like new generation dresses like.
Mm.
They cut this thing here, no? The dresses like rags. But yesterday, that idea comes to my mind. Today's fashion, maybe the tomorrow's reality.
Very well said. So we can make out that you are totally humorous. So how humorous you are with your family members, we would also want to know that.
I don't know how they do it. Some
how do they react to your cartoons?
No, my cartoons. No, like common readers.
Mm.
Their reactions are like very common readers, not a special reaction.
Do they give you any tips like you have to do this, this time, or today's edition was like this?
Oh, don't like that. But when I at home, I'm just become my role is like a simple family member. not a cartoonist.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right. Champak sir, we were talking about how you started up your journey and everything about it. So, you please tell us something about what imagination you do. As you said, the things which come up to you, whatever the developments are going on, the present situation and those things you pen down in your cartoon. So, other than that, like sometimes do you have to give a lot of like tense to your mind and imagine a lot about things? Like if suppose something has happened and you have picked up that topic but you are a bit confused about the topic, so how do you solve those confusions?
I didn't know that the cartoon, first thing, it is a visual things. And you have to say something visually, first thing. Visually, not literally. So, I have to think it, interpret it in visual language. How it is completely different from literacy, and first thing. And so, I have to, when I build up a cartoon or so construct a cartoon, I have to relate that happenings or topic to some visual things first.
Okay.
How I visualize it. And that is the language of the cartoon.
So first you visualize
the thing.
Okay.
Then the some punchlines are there, some punchline are there. But the punchline is always a part of it and it relate to it. Though it relate to it. But main thing is the visual things. The whole expressions is there, no, the cartoon. Then the like a scene, no, but someone talking or some happenings like scenes
things
are there, no. So I have to first visualize this and then a very comical way.
So, is it sometimes very difficult for you to pen down those cartoons in your from your imagination, because it might create some controversies as well, because we have seen and we have heard about some controversies regarding the cartoon. And have you faced any of the controversies?
No, I have not. Actually, thing is that there's a cartoons, it is for the sensible person. I am till date, I have not found any controversy about my cartoon, though I did many harsh cartoons, but no reaction is there. I think the other politicians or the people are not so much sensible. to react.
It might or might not sometime hurt someone's sentiments also.
No, I don't want to hurt anybody's sentiments, but I want to criticize the political situations, like policy on policy makings, and other things their deeds, those who are not invariably favor of the common people or society but as a whole.
As a whole, you see everyone as a whole. You don't see like if I have taken up a topic about politics, so I'll be bit careful, and if I've taken up a topic about some common people, so but you see simultaneously, you do things simultaneously. You don't see someone or the other hand with other eye or something like that. So these imaginations come up to you and it comes up with all the section and the section joke or serious. We would like to ask him, how did that topic or the header came to your mind, joke or serious? Was it your idea or
the headline,
the joke or serious?
The headline was actually I inherited this joke or serious. Earlier it was done by our senior cartoonist who retired retired from Assam Tribune, Trolliko Dutto. And then I want to join him, join Assam Tribune. Then I inherit this headline to Joko Serious.
Okay.
And then I continued it.
Okay, so this thing happened and now till now the Joko Serious section comes up and we always wait for the Assam Tribune, that section of Joko Serious, and we always come up with the thing that today what would be that Joko Serious section would like to be. And sir, I would also like to ask you that, do you read lots of comics? As you imagine, a lot, but do you also have a fond of like reading lots of comics and...
Actually, you know, I am not habituated to comic, but I love comic, like Donald Duck, Mickey Mouse, and they release some tension and that joy you get from the very pure joy. From the comics, and then some other comics also, like Phantom likes some adventure comics. But nowadays the other things come, it is called graphic novel. That is the graphic novels, perhaps you know that it is like novels, but it is like it's tell a story.
Tells a story.
Yes, it is maybe social or political story, but the mode of expression is different, and is different, and is varies from artist to artist, and they stylize it. There one very famous graphics novels like Persepolis. Like that.
So, which are the favorite genres you would you like to pen down in your cartoons? Is it political? Is it entertainment related to some of the star cast or anything?
Anything. Whatever it comes to my mind.
Mostly politics.
Mostly politics. Yeah, right.
Okay. It was so nice talking to you. But we have to move to our next segment. That's the birthday wish segment, and let's see who we share our birthday with today. All the birthday boys and girls, you share your birthday with all these renowned personalities. So coming back to Champak sir, so I would also like to ask you that what is the future of a cartoonist, and how have you seen these days and the past days, how have things changed, what have been changed and what are still the same you have been seeing throughout the days?
If you see the cartoons in the nowadays comparing to the earlier days, in the national perspective, you would find that the spaces for the cartoons coming less day by day, because in my case also I did political cartoons in Assam Tribune first, then I political cartoons purely political. Then I shifted it to Dainik Akhom, the another publications from our group. And there is three columns in the first phase. And then what happens now, so for the survival of the papers, you have to carry advertisement. So the space, the most of the space covered by the advertisement, then the news, important news are also there. So the spaces for the cartoons is become less. You see the if you see Hindu, now they carry the main political cartoons in the editorial piece. Nowadays they're not coming in the front piece. So the cartoons are getting less important.
Nowadays generation are more attracted to these kind of
But things I am very lucky that at at least I've gotten one space, small, maybe it's very small, but regular space in the front piece. Okay. And it is very important thing.
Of course, the leading daily of exam.
And I have to utilize it, you know, my views on the, and it is the view of the papers also, like editorials. Mm-hmm. It may be the view of the paper also. Mm-hmm. So I have to. One, the cartoonist must be serious about it, I think.
Because like any other column of that newspaper, that column is also very much important.
It conveys a message to the people, no?
So it's one kind of message we are putting towards
our viewers. So one should be serious about it, one cartoonist should be serious about it.
That's the tagline, Joko serious.
Yeah, Joko, yes.
Okay. Last question to you. What would you tell to the budding talents who would come up to cartoonist and who would take profession as a cartoonist? So your words on to them.
Now one should, I think, aware of his surroundings first. We should be sensible to the society and should read many things. So that one can go to the depth of things, no? So one must be humorous first. The sense must be there, and once the practice of drawing, these things are necessary for a cartoonist, I think.
Okay, so one should be humorous, and humorous like Champak Borbora. I like to tell
you.
We have seen your work, so it says all that you are too humorous, and the work of Champak Borbora says all, and he has told all the budding talents who want to take up profession as cartoonist to think a lot and should have a good skills of drawing, and you imagine a lot and things will come up soon, isn't it?
Yeah.
So it was so nice talking to you, sir, and we had so much to talk to you. We are short of time, and you have given a lot of inspiration to all the budding talents who are planning to take up cartoon as their profession in the near future, and we had a lot to talk to you, but we have to just leave the show right now. So thank you so much, sir, for coming to our show.
Thank
Good Morning
you,
Northeast. So that was the noted cartoonist Champak Borbora with us, giving us all the updates, giving us all the latest, how he took up the profession. And apart from cartoonist, he is also a painter, which he revealed today in our show Good Morning Northeast.